Enough trouble trying to protect my only son from every catchpenny princess that comes along. Now I'm surrounded by spies and traitors. Whom can I trust?
Me.
No one. And now I've another one of those princesses to cope with. I'm in no mood to sit for hours in a stuffy chamber and rack my brains over a test for that girl when I'm not feeling well at all. But that's the way darkness wants it. So that's the way it'll be. She'll have her test.
Well, her paper seems to be good.
I know. And the worst of it is that foolish boy actually seems to like the girl. So we must think of a test that looks fair and sounds fair and seems fair and isn't fair. When you got the idea of testing her for sensitivity, I could have applauded right out loud. What exactly do you want? No, that's not good enough. I'm just loaded with doubt. In this one word is the epitome of the aristocrat. Sensitive soul and sensitive stomach, sensitive hands and feet. This is the blessing, also the curse of being a true elite. Common people don't know what exquisite agony is. Suffered by gentle people like me. Just get your hands off me and think up a tricky test for that wretched moat swimming princess. Don't take all night, I'm not well, I need my rest. Not that I'll ever sleep on that lumpy mattress, so no, my back. Sensitivity, bane of royalty, that bed's a torture rack. Oh, I hate to sound grumpy, but my nerves are so jumpy. I am sure I could feel any lump, even if it were under the mattress. And small as a pea, that's the answer, under the mattress. We'll test her tonight. One tiny pea beneath one thick downy mattress. Oh God, you're bright. Any genuine princess would feel it if she doesn't, she's through. Get the tiniest pea and order one mattress. No, make it two. Ten, I think, would be plenty. Better still, make it 20. And in any case, in the event, even that's not enough.